Is art a challenge or a race for the most beautiful painting? Or can it also be about other things? How about doing your own research while painting and still make interesting artwork? Welcome to the world of Hans Hartung, just after this. Hi there, my name is Albert van der Zwart. Welcome to Imperfect Paintings, where it's all about improving your painting skills by looking at art yourself and the world around you. Hans Hartung is a German-French painter who lived from 1904 until 1989. He is known for his gestural abstract paintings like these. His artwork is related to Tachisme, coming from the French word for stain, tache. At first it all may look like random scratches or scribbles, but I find it quite fascinating art to look into. Gordon, thanks for introducing me to his art. Let's warm up using several materials, trying out things or studying and learning. You'll never enter the game just before the finish line and make smashing art instantly. Just start, explore and discover what you love to do and do more of that. But also open yourself to coincidence or happenstance. As you can see, each material has its own appearance and characteristics. A small or wide line, neat or messy. I chose this approach after looking at the art of Hans Hartung. This sheet may not look like much, just some lines. What if I place another one in the center? Even isolate it. And now frame it. You will perhaps start looking at it differently. This is why doing research or homework is so valuable. An attitude of playfulness or allowing yourself to mess up can also help. Hans Hartung liked to experiment. And when you look in his studio, you see this table with an endless amount of brushes and other tools. I also found this photograph. Look at these magnificent brushes. He used them to make art like this. But he also used giant ones, like here. So I cut some reed, or water reed, and prepare some more fluid black paint by mixing it with diluted acrylic medium. I let the paint soak in a little and start painting. This may look strange, but here is a picture of Hans Hartung again. Link up here for a short video where he paints using this giant brush. The effect of such a giant brush is really different. When it would be made with a small brush, you would see all the individual brush strokes. I take a new sheet and continue painting from different sides. And one more sheet with only one stroke. What? Come again? I love this. It's painted and it also looks very natural. It's a print of a branch with leaves. When we go back to the first one and zoom in, you can find these wonderful spots. In the second one, we see this. When we go back to Hans Hartung art, you see similar stains, spots and lines. And you see what color in the background can do. I guess Hartung can be seen as a so-called painter's painter. He influenced a lot of artists with his art. For an interesting video about it, link up here. A quick question. What color has a stain? Before you start asking questions, you probably had this primal internal image attached to the word stain. Was it a dark stain? On a lighter background? Or the other way around? Was it a red one? Or blue? I walked around at my day job to take pictures of the concrete floor. I work in an industrial environment, so I see all these different versions. But for me is a stain a darker one on a lighter background. So I went to the discounter to buy a cheap black acrylic spray can to play with, but I also could have used white on a black background. This is also part of my experiments, to question my standards and automatic reactions. A stain or cloud? What is it? Is it blocking my view on the background? Or is it coming towards me? Internally I find it challenging. Can I make art with a spray can? I know what you see here is far from being art, but I find it interesting to investigate. Without notice, my mind shifts from spraying to composition. What size would be interesting and where? No matter what you use, a brush, your fingers or a spray can, it all comes down to this. Investigate what you do. Be in the moment. Observe what happens and be open to and aware of questions that arise. Does this help to create what I want? Can I stretch my ideas about the tools I can use? The images that appear or emerge? How do I feel about the mist created by the spray can, creating this cloud-like thing that has no clear boundaries? What if I first paint a blue shape? I do some more experiments, and even though I opened the window, my family didn't like me for an hour because of the chemical smells. But it was raining outside, so I had no other option. A red line at the bottom. I use an old membership card to create it. I use a leftover piece of paper to block the spray. I find it interesting to see how the spray flows around the piece of paper, creating this mist around the corner. Another one with a yellow painted shape and a smaller piece of paper. Amazing! Like a light is shining on the yellow from underneath the black. I notice the spray is still wet and I take a credit card and make some marks. In this close-up you see the effect. I wasn't making these, they were just tools. By coincidence, they became interesting to look at too. As you can see, experiments never stop. I also looked at the clouds this week and saw these in the morning and these in the afternoon. They never stopped to amaze me. What brings me to a next one, using an older brush. And here the last one, using a palette knife. I redo a little piece, but perhaps all done in one move would look more interesting. I know Hans Hartung wasn't just looking for random stains, so this is more my childlike nature in action. Do keep in mind though, in my opinion, painting is also about having fun and not taking yourself too seriously. One last quick experiment with painting knives. I start by putting some paint on the sheet. Just by doing the same routine, but using a different sized tool, the outcome will look different. Logical perhaps, but by actually doing it, you can find out what the real difference is. and you so can discover the last one creates unexpected problems. When I put them next to each other, you can make your choice which one you like best. Or keep them all for later reference. And here you see some Hans Hartung artwork, in my opinion, related to this exercise. If you like to experiment and would like to see some more ideas to investigate your art making process, I can recommend you another video where I play with the idea of repetition in art. And of course I also show you some artists who play with the idea of repetition. Click on the link and I will see you over there in the next video.